The bitwise.yaml file is the heart of your Bitwise configuration. It contains all the workflows, steps, and step inputs that tell Bitwise how to run your build. By default, this file is stored on bitwise.io, but if you want to, you can store it in the AppSong repository. That way, you have full control over the versioning, maintenance, and security of your Bitwise configuration. If you choose the option of storing the bitwise.yaml file in your repo, your builds will be run using that file. This also means that every time you want to make a change to your Bitwise configuration, for example, adding a new step to a workflow, you need to commit the modified bitwise.yaml file to the repo. Setting this up is simple, even if your repo doesn't contain a bitwise.yaml file. Just open your app on Bitwise, go to the workflow editor, and then go to the bitwise.yaml tab. Right at the top, you'll see the question, where do you want to store the bitwise.yaml file? Choose the Store in App Repository option. Don't worry, it's reversible at any time. You'll be prompted to add a bitwise.yaml file to the repository. Here, you have two options. You can copy the content of your app's current bitwise.yaml file to the clipboard. If you do this, then you have to create a bitwise.yaml file on your computer, paste the content, save it, and then commit the file to the root directory of your app's repository. Or you can download the current bitwise.yaml file from our website. In this case, you just need to find the file on your computer and then commit it to the root directory of your app's repository. Once you're done and the file is committed to the repo, click Update Settings. You'll see a warning. It's there to make sure that the bitwise.yaml file in the repository is valid. That's super important because with an invalid bitwise.yaml, your build simply won't run. You can check out the basic requirements of a valid bitwise.yaml format in our documentation. If the file is valid, you'll see a nice green message informing you of your success. From now on, Bitwise will look for your bitwise.yaml file in the app's repository. Now, as we said earlier, this also means that wherever you make changes using the graphical UI of the workflow editor on bitwise.io, you will have to commit those changes to the bitwise.yaml file in the repo. But don't worry, we'll warn you about that so you won't forget it. Let's see an example. Go to the Workflows tab in the workflow editor and add a new step to a workflow. Click the Save button. You'll get a pop-up that prompts you to update the bitwise.yaml file in the repository. Just like earlier, you can choose between copying the content of the file or downloading the entire file. When you committed the changes to your repo, click I'm done. Bitwise will fetch the updated file and refresh the workflow editor. Try it out. If keeping the config file in the repo doesn't work out for you, you can just always revert to storing it on bitwise.io so that we take care of it for you. See you in the next one.